We have a number of folks who have gone to the WBAL Facebook page and have questions for you. If you don't mind, we'll put you to work.
I love it.
Dr. Oz, one of the things as a caregiver that I don't do is take care of myself. My husband survived a bone marrow transplant. He's doing great, but it's burning me out. Give me some advice on what to do to take care of me.
Big problem in America right now are folks who are the caregivers. And there's actually a definition of that. People spend 17 hours or more, which is a lot of people, taking care of other folks, are considered caregivers. And there's a sandwich generation. They take care of their kids and their parents.
Mm-hmm.
The upshot is, if you're not taking care of yourself, you're not going to be able to take care of the people you love for very long. And so as healers and as a physician, and I still practice, as you know, I spend a lot of time just trying to recharge the engine. So a couple little tips. One, you got to make time for yourself. It's hard to do that because emotionally you're so tied into the pain your loved ones are feeling. But even if it's 5 minutes a day, and I have a bit of advice to the women out there, go to the bathroom because people won't bother you there. Don't actually go to the bathroom. Just go into the bathroom
just
and sit there.
Just close the door.
Exactly. Sit on the lid and just spend 5 minutes thinking about what you're grateful for.
Uh-huh.
The second thing is, you know, you cannot be bashful about asking for help yourself. One of the biggest challenges we face, I think, as a people, because we tend to be a given population, is we don't like to take. But you got to learn to take. It's hard to do it, but it makes